I'm here with Brad Johnner at the Stonebridge location of Rock Creek, and so happy to have Brad as my guest. Last week was Jay Semko. I think I'm going to talk to T-Bone next week because nobody else will talk to him. But the thing is, I just want to sit and have a chat with you about your life and music and stuff like that, and everything that you do, the impact the province of Saskatchewan. Right. And I know we're starting to hear a wee bit about Telemarico coming up again right away here, but it's all of a sudden with Christmas and then it feels like Telemarico.
That's right.
Do you remember your first time on Telemarico?
Yeah, I do. I was 13 years old.
13?
My brother Ken and I and my brother Randy and my dad, we all went and auditioned for the 50 spots that are available for Saskatchewan talent. And we got in and we went to Regina and we were on, I think it was Telemarico 3.
Wow.
At the time I remember thinking, oh, Telemarico's been on for years.
Yeah.
And it was only the third year that we got on, performed, and Bob McGrath that year. So.
Yeah. And have you done it every year since?
Not every year since. Okay. No, I'm not sure. Ken and I, as the Johnner brothers, were asked to go on there 5-6 times or something like that. And then I, as a solo artist, I've been on there for the last, I'm not sure, I think 20 years I've been on there. So.
Wow. Yeah. And we were just talking about your sons and it's the impact they're having at the minute. And I know they have a new album coming out. There are a couple of songs away from finishing that album and stuff. As they were growing up, and I mean, as they continue to grow, do they, you don't want anything, do you?
Do we want a couple menus at all? Something to drink?
No, I'm good, thanks.
No.
We're good. We're low maintenance. I'm all right.
Okay,
thank you.
Well, if you see me,
let me talk. Appreciate it. Thank you. So, was the conversation always around music? Or did you ever say, are you sure, guys? Or was it just, they just wanted to do it because they saw Dad do it?
It was never around music. They didn't even know. In fact, some of my boys, one time they were maybe 6-7 years old before they knew what I did for a living. They didn't, I was tuning my guitar one day and one of the boys came running into the kitchen and said, Mom, Dad's playing the guitar. And they didn't even know I played it. Because I never, I was on the road so much and played so much. And you get home, it was just a time to relax and get away from the music and just spend time with the family.
Yeah.
And so they never even saw me pull out the guitar. And that was the first time when I just changed the strings on it that they were amazed.
Wow.
But and they took piano lessons like every other kid, you know. But I didn't even know they played or music or wanted to play music until one day they were down there playing 100 songs and they didn't know the beginning or ending of any of them, so we got together.
That sounds like me.
Yeah. Me too. It's like, the older I get, the less I can remember.
5 chords? Why? You can do it with 3, it's fine.
That's right. You know? If I break a string, I'm going to be...
Oh, I know. What would you do? It's like, I'm kind of sex. So the thing is, like, going back, do you remember the first time that your music was on the radio? Do you remember that part?
Yeah. Well, when I was 16 years old, I entered a contest, and the Canadian National Contest, and I won. And the prize was the 45-40. So I recorded 2 songs, and I was at school. It was in grade 10.
Yeah.
And I was going for lunch. I jumped in my truck with my 2 buddies, and we're driving across town to go for lunch, and my song came on the radio. And we were all freaking out. So it was the coolest moment.
Wow. Did you, when you put your first album together, because this is something I struggle with, the continuity of your album, the kind of in the beginning, the middle, and the end, and the almost like a storybook thing, is that something you still struggle with or not anymore because you've been doing it for a long time? But is it on your mind?
I just remember the first album being very, every song being very different.
Mm-hmm.
Like we had a very, very traditional country song.
Yeah.
It was the first one we recorded. The second song was a very pop country song. And then we went to a bluegrass song. And it was just songs that I had written and was writing for this album. And you don't know what your sound is supposed to be like.
Right.
Or you're just recording what you write.
Mm-hmm.
So you write these songs and pretty soon they're coming out a bluegrass style. I guess there was a bluegrass influence in me. So I came out with a bluegrass song. So it was very, and I find the boys album, now that we're working on this album, we have all 10 songs.
Okay.
And some songs are totally different than other songs.
Yeah,
no, they're just so different. So they're trying to find their
Well, I was going to say, and the thing is, other people have talked to about this, is with the Johnner boys, when you've got 3, 4, 5, 6 people involved, is there quality control there within the band? So if you bring a song, an original song to the table, it has to go through all those gates first, right? Before it makes the album?
Yeah, you know, my oldest boy Lucas, it's kind of the songwriter on this whole project.
Okay.
I mean, there's my boy Quinn wrote a song for this album, and Simon, our friend, he wrote a song for this album as well. But for the most part, Luke sits down and writes these songs, and he brings them to me, and I go, man, that's a, where'd you come up with that one? That's a good one. And I think if we change this and add this, and I think it'd be great. But he's pretty much got it wrapped up. And so we take it into the studio and go, what do you think of this? And then the guys go, yeah, that's great. And if we and then everybody figures out their part. And
then you put it down?
Yeah, put it down.
That's
do a rough demo of it.
Yeah.
And everybody kind of figures out what they want to do. Go in and record it. You know?
Awesome.
So it's good to have. What I like about that project is that it's not just going and getting a bunch of studio cats to come and play the song. They're actually playing their instrument on the album, just like we did on our first album.
Yeah, it's cool. Awesome. You're watching Rock Creek TV with Brad Joner, my guest today, and we'll be back after this.